Hey, Marcus Housewithy here. Yes, you are right. It is certainly not Saturday. So what is this video all about? I mean, you've seen the title, you've clicked on the thumbnail, so you've got a few hints already. Well, some very exciting and long-awaited news over the last day. The Federal Aviation Administration has finally released the 2021 Programmatic Environmental Assessment for Starbase and their findings alongside it. SpaceX has been granted a Mitigated FONSI, which stands for Finding of No Significant Impact, with many mitigations already in place, of course. Alongside this, the final PEA document has been published, with SpaceX securing the environmental approval from the FAA to conduct orbital Starship launches on the South Texas coast. So yes, this is terrific news, and after 12 months of work and several monthly delays, the FAA has ultimately issued SpaceX extremely favorable plans to conduct these orbital Starship launches out of Starbase in Texas. This has overcome one of the most difficult regulatory barriers for the future of Starbase. In fact, SpaceX soon chimed in on their own Twitter account, tweeting that they were one step closer to the first orbital flight test of Starship. So we are going to be seeing a huge push now, just like the announcement that we saw last week. So we are going to be seeing the fully stacked Starship launching for sure now, right? Well, we aren't quite that far. Before SpaceX can receive the actual launch license, they must mitigate dozens of environmental impact points, including protecting fish, wildlife, plants, and other environmental resources. They also need to reduce the closures of the beaches, the parks, and highways, which will be a bit of a shift from what they would have probably liked. So to address all of the stuff in the report and put the appropriate systems in place, it's still going to take a significant amount of work, specifically, I think, to at least partially alleviate some of the launch site's environmental impact. Along with this, they must also meet the safety, risk, and financial responsibility requirements. SpaceX has already begun that process, of course, with the FAA, but it could still take many weeks after the final PEA to secure an operator license or experimental permit. In many ways, though, it's a bit simpler than what SpaceX initially requested in its September 2021 draft. Aside from the already expected removal of the on-site methane fuel production and all of the associated facilities, the rest of the final PEA appears to be surprisingly close to SpaceX's Starbase draft PEA. Now, what I think is great is that thankfully SpaceX was not forced to reduce the number of permitted orbital launches, suborbital launches, or ship and booster static fire tests that they originally requested. So that is a really big win. So ultimately for SpaceX and the amazing team at Starbase in Boca Chica, Texas, it is an extremely positive outcome. There is very little doubt now that SpaceX will complete all of the mitigations requested of it and help improve aspects of Starbase Texas as a result. Now I'll dive into this more as this story unfolds in our weekly update videos, always released on Saturday, along with a great deal of other interesting space news. So thanks to all of you subscribers here that have helped us get through this quite lengthy period of uncertainty. And just a quick update on last weekend's video here in the top right if you missed this one. I had shared the announcement that the NASA James Webb Space Telescope team was going to release its first full color images and spectroscopic data on July the 12th. Well, for some silly reason, my brain didn't quite work out that they said July 12th and not June the 12th. I even said July 12th in the video, so yes, I was implying that these images would have been released by now, not a month from now as it will actually be. So yes, oops, I did pin a comment there with no shortage of replies laughing about that one. Hey, you've got to own your own mistakes, don't you? So yes, I hope this news has brightened your day. It certainly has brightened mine. If you scroll through the comment threads from these videos over the last few months, there are just so many people that said that the FAA would never approve it, that no orbital Starship would ever fly from Texas. Hopefully, this has finally put those comments to rest. This is a complex system, and it needs all the appropriate approval processes to take their course, as frustrating as they can be. I think with hindsight, if anything, the FAA could have been able to predict with a little more certainty the time frame that we were really talking here. But then saying that, everything with space takes longer than we would all like. Elon Musk is no exception. Also, just quickly, be sure to check out Tim Dodd's third part discussion with Musk linked in the description. It was really interesting listening to the discussions around Falcon 9's Merlin engine in particular. They talk about some of the early decisions there, and the Raptor engine for Starship is just so much more complicated. It's not hard to see why Merlin was the best decision for getting SpaceX off the ground, literally. Anyway, I'll see you again on Saturday. On screen are some more of our deep dive videos here if you haven't seen any of those. Enjoy the rest of the week, and I'll see you in the next video.